Hi there, I'm Chris Berkeley, I'm a digital marketing consultant, and this is part two of my video about redirect chains. In part one, I talked about what redirect chains are, their implications for SEO, and in this video, part two, I'll talk about how to find them and what to do with them. And the first thing you have to do in order to find redirect chains is you have to start with a group of old URLs. I have three ways that I'll really use to find these, and I'll walk you through those now.
Okay, so I said I had three strategies to find redirect chains, and it's actually more like four. All four of those strategies are going to use the paid version of the Screaming Frog SEO Spider. And remember that our initial goal here is to find a list of URLs that we can then use Screaming Frog to crawl, and Screaming Frog will find the redirect chains for us. And strategies one and two are going to give us a list of URLs that we can then put into Screaming Frog. While strategies three and four, we're going to use Screaming Frog itself to find those URLs directly. So I'm going to use phillymag.com as an example. This is not a client of mine, but it's a website that's been around a long time and probably has some redirect chains. So strategy one, we're going to use Google Analytics. And while I don't actually have Google Analytics access for phillymag.com, I'm going to show you how to do it on one of my websites in the same manner. So we'll go into Google Analytics and we'll go to Acquisition, into Channels, and then select Organic Search. And then once we're in there, we're going to set the date range to as far back as possible, and then go down and make sure that our primary dimension is landing page, and then go all the way down to the bottom and set that to 5,000 so we get as many as possible. And then we'll go up top and click Export CSV, and this will export a spreadsheet of all the old landing pages that received traffic at one time, and that's probably going to contain a lot of old URLs. Method number two is also going to find us a list of URLs, but with this one we're going to use a tool by Moz called Open Site Explorer. This is a free tool if you create an account with them, which is awesome, and this is going to find all the backlinks pointing to a particular website. So we'll copy phillymag.com's URL, and we'll put it in the search bar here. And then this is going to give us all the backlinks, but we want a version that we can export. So we're going to make sure the target here is set to the root domain, so we get all the backlinks pointing to the site. We're going to keep the link source as only external. And then the link type we'll set to link equity, so we only get links that are driving net link equity. And then you can request CSV, and you'll get you can export a spreadsheet with a list of those URLs. So now we're going to use Screaming Frog to crawl those lists of URLs. But first, we need to adjust a couple settings in Screaming Frog. So first, we'll make sure that under Mode, we've selected List Mode. Secondly, we'll make sure we go to Configuration, Spider. And then under the Advanced tab, make sure you check the box that says Always Follow Redirects, and click OK. And then the third setting is under Configuration, Robots.txt settings, and make sure that you've checked the Ignore Robots.txt box. From there, you can go into either of your lists, either your export from Google Analytics or your export from Moz, and copy all of, in this case, the PhillyMag.com pages. Go into Screaming Frog, click Upload, Paste, it'll enter them, and you click OK, and it starts crawling them. Now here, I'm going to pause, I'm going to stop, and I'm going to actually show you strategies three and four, and then we'll loop back around to what you do with the final output once Screaming Frog is done crawling all of these. In strategy three, we're going to use Screaming Frog to actually crawl the site, and what that's going to do is going to find any redirect chains that are currently on the site. So first, we're going to go into Screaming Frog. And again, we're going to remember we have to change those settings. So we're going to change the mode to Spider off of List Mode. We're going to go to Configuration, Spider, Advanced, Always Follow Redirects, and then back in Configuration, Robots.txt settings, and Ignore Robots.txt. These are the same settings that we did before, but when you change from List Mode to Spider Mode, you have to reset them because Screaming Frog forgets your settings. So then we'll grab the phillymag.com URL, take it into Screaming Frog, and we will just start crawling it. And then we'll let that run until it finishes. Now, strategy four is going to do something fairly similar. but it's a little bit more complex. So we're going to go to the Wayback Machine, which is archive.org/web, and we're going to take the phillymag.com URL and put it in there. Now, what the Wayback Machine does is it archives old web pages and URLs as they existed. And what this would let us do is we can pick any number of older years here and then see what the website looked like at that time and then crawl it and get the URLs from it. So I already have a 2011 loaded in another tab here. So we'll just grab this, and you can see it contains the exact phillymag.com URL. We'll copy that. We'll go back to Screaming Frog, and we'll start over by crawling web.archive.org, the cached phillymag.com version. So you can see it's already starting to populate URLs here. Now, this is a little more complex because what you have to do here is you're actually going to get these. You'll need to export a list of them and remove the web.archive.org part so that you have the just the phillymag.com URL. So this is definitely the most tedious method, but this is a good way to find older URLs if everything else fails. And then once you've done that, so once all your crawls have finished, whether you've run a crawl on a list or you've run a crawl on the site itself, you'll need to go into reports and then redirect chains. And that'll basically export a CSV of the redirect chains, which is going to look like this. And I'll go up top. First thing I'll do is I'll filter this. And you can see the third column here is redirect loop. So in my last video, I talked about redirect chains versus redirect loops. And Screaming Frog will inherently look for any possible loops. So we can go largest to smallest. And I don't see true in there. So there are no redirect loops that Screaming Frog found, and that's good. And then I'll sort by the number of redirects, smallest to largest. And you can see, so we've got at least two URLs that have four redirect chains, three redirect chains, and then quite a bit more that have two. You can ignore any redirect chains that have one, because that's not a redirect chain. That's just a single redirect, and there's nothing wrong there. The one thing I'll do with this in order to manipulate the data and show me any possible errors is I'll just add some conditional formatting. And I'm going to highlight the cells that are equal to 302. Do that in yellow. Because a 302 does not pass as much link equity as a 301. So right off the bat, we can say we have a 302. And we'll also do some conditional formatting to highlight any cells that say 404 in red. So then this will give us an easy way to scan pretty quickly and figure out how big of a problem we might have even outside of redirect chains. Obviously, 302s don't pass the link equity that 301s do. So you might have a redirect chain that's not desirable, but that's even worse. And then if we scroll down a little bit more, we can see that we got some 404s in here too. So if you ping the single URL, it might return 301. But then when you look, you'll find that you actually might have a 404 as the end destination. So this is basically covers everything we'd want to do with redirect chains. And again, you can manipulate this data in any number of ways and run a few different reports to find all the redirect chains that are possible.
That wraps it up for redirect chains. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. If you liked this video and you'd like to see more like it, feel free to subscribe to my channel and also check out chrisberkley.com for other marketing tips and topics. Thanks.